It's Christmas time. That means repeats.
Tonight on Dispatches, how much does it cost to hire a politician?
Well, essentially, I am a whore. I'm for hire. I'll pretty much do anything if you pay me enough. I mean, anything you want.
How far will you go?
Oh, it depends. It depends on the job, depends on the client. A good way of describing it, I mean, yeah. I'm a slut.
Lord Pearson, head of UKIP, thinks he's about to be interviewed by Al Jazeera London.
What he doesn't know is that Guy News is on his tail, and we're going to be investigating why UKIP wants to ban the burqa.
Eurosceptic Muslims who might be interested in voting for UKIP, will this not push them away?
I don't know what will happen to Eurosceptic Muslims. Some of them may come our way, some of them may go the other way.
I like to think of myself as a strategic gigolo, I think would be fair.
Mm. Sure. I came back to these shivering shores to read stories that there's another coup being mounted against the Prime Minister. And from a position of zero knowledge, I'd like to say to you, I don't believe a word of it.
And you're right. Not
really?
To believe a word of it.
Shall we move on? All right, bye.
I'm just going to go straight to Westminster and join our political editor, Nick Robinson.
Two former senior cabinet ministers, Jeff Hoon and Pat Hewitt, are texting all of their Labour MP colleagues to call for a secret ballot on Gordon Brown's leadership.
Just first of all say, that'll teach me.
But then, later in the day, Nick managed to add to his own misery. He infuriated Jack Straw by announcing, unsubstantiated, that Jack was a potential supporter of the plot to oust the Prime Mentalist.
I was named by Mr. Nick Robinson of the BBC. He sent me an apology for the fact he never bothered to check that claim, and he's now himself rowing back from it on his own blog and what he's saying today. It was a very substandard piece of journalism.
Ouch. Nick has now apologised to Jack Straw.
Just first of all say, that'll teach me.
It's 7 o'clock. It's Guy News. Do you know where your pundits are?
It's on. It's game time. Finally, Gordon fired the starting gun, and it took him just 2 hours to humiliate himself.
Mr. Brown headed for a supermarket in Kent.
What age are you?
Five.
My son's six.
That would be 10, Gordon. 10. This is 5. This is 10.
See, I agree with Nick. See, I agree with Nick.
I think we all agree about that.
I actually starting to agree, strongly agree.
Where Nick and I are agreed, I agree with Nick. We want.
Of course, I agree with that.
I agree that we need to do more.
Well, it's rather difficult because Gordon says Nick agrees with Gordon and Nick says Nick doesn't agree with Gordon.
How do you drive this thing?
You let Guido drive.
Welcome to Guy News. We bring you the biggest news in the biggest way possible. We're going to go live now to the biggest event of the day, which was, of course, the launch of the Big Tory Manifesto. Tory Bear is there now. What's it like there, Tory Bear?
Well, I just can't get over it. It's a very, very big event. The whole thing is huge. As I'm sure you can see from the footage from the Guy Copter there, this is big. And I wasn't the only one that thought so.
David Cameron's great big...
The big society.
It's just been too big. It's basically been too big, all the ideas that
have... The big government. A big idea. This big opening up.
Political editor Adam Bolton's just arrived as well. Quite an impressive sight here, Adam, isn't it?
The biggest call to arms...
It is a super good manifesto. It's the first of its kind in Britain.
You're live on Guy News now, Tory Bear. What's the atmosphere like?
That was it. The big speech. And I can't believe how many shadow cabinet members there were in one room and not one gaffe. Look how unscripted it was. They're all allowed to express their own views in their own special way.
So please accept this invitation.
So please accept this invitation.
Accept this invitation.
So please accept this invitation.
So please accept this invitation.
So please accept this invitation.
Vince Cable, you have dined out on a reputation for honesty and being more far-seeing in this economic crisis than Mr. Darling and Mr. Osborne. But in October 2008, you said it was entirely wrong for the government to stimulate the economy with more public spending. 4 months later, you said that the government was right to stimulate it. You described quantitative easing, printing of money, as the Robert Mugabe School of Economics. You later supported it. You originally supported the Lloyds TSB takeover of HBOS, and then you claimed that Lloyds was being dragged down by HBOS. You told the government not to tell the Bank of England what to do about interest rates. A few weeks later, you urged the government to tell the bank what to do about interest rates. Isn't the biggest myth of this election your reputation?
Certainly isn't.
Welcome to the Sky Spin Room, a writhing, sweating pit of journalists where politicians and politicos try to tell us what to think. But what really goes on in this seedy back alley of politics? Bad Al Campbell was in full flow tutoring his little Blairite protege, David Miliband. Professional Al made David cover his mic so we couldn't hear what he was saying, but we caught up with David later.
Did Alistair Campbell give you some good lines?
I would never admit to Alistair Campbell feeding me lines.
It's all right, David. You don't have to admit it. It's on camera. At least no one was lacking powder.
Well, that's a record.
My family have voted Labour all the life. As I should have. Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Little things I should have said and done.
Oh, everything. She's just a sort of bigoted woman. It's ridiculous.
Tell me that your sweet love hasn't died.
That has said that.
Labour unveiled posters it hopes will help. The launch was interrupted by a car crash.
Creating tax fairness, making sure that our pledges for child tax benefit.
They're fed, they're briefed, and they're ready to be spun.
And who do you want to be your next Prime Minister?
But hold on, what's this? A technical glitch. The screen has gone off, but luckily the taxpayer has paid for an emergency one.
So what you're saying is John Craig there, about the polling companies getting results they want from people in their positions. Is that the actual thing?
Well, it's a figure of speech.
There was even time to catch up with everyone's favourite boss, Liam Byrne.
Yesterday was yesterday, and what people focus on in the question about how the country is going to be governed for the next 5 years is substance. You know, and it's the substance of the economic argument, I think, that is really uppermost in voters' minds.
And I will not let you down. I take responsibility on this programme. I apologise to the people of this country for what happened. I am angry and I am appalled and I will not let you down. I'm sorry about what happened. I've said all along that when I saw this first, I was horrified, I was shocked and I was very angry indeed. And I will not let you down.
I will let you down.